Hey everyone, welcome to Radeon Rewind. I'm Adit.
And I'm Isaac.
We're back with our second episode.
And we got budget, and we got a cameraman.
Yes.
Thanks, Warren. We've been absolutely loving the community feedback and seeing your comments on YouTube and Twitter. Please keep it up and let us know what you want to see in future episodes, and we'll do our best to make sure it's incorporated.
That's right. We got a new poll coming out on Twitter, so don't forget to follow Adit and myself. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and continue to engage with us.
So, Isaac, I think we have a pretty jam-packed episode this time around.
It's exciting, man. This episode, we're breaking it down into a few segments so you can really get a full understanding of what we're trying to do here at Radeon Rewind.
To start, we're going to take a look at Dead Island 2. Me and Isaac are both huge zombie fans, as you can tell by our last episode as well. And, you know, we've been waiting over 10 years for this game to come out. We are so excited to get started on our co-op playthrough.
That's right. Adit's probably going to have to carry me.
Probably, but that's okay.
That being said, our next segment's going to be on our monthly tech tip. If you have any questions in the YouTube comments or on Twitter, wherever you can find us, let us know and we'll do our best to address those comments, whether it's about AMD hardware or AMD software. Last but not least, we'll wrap up with some AMD software optimizations, how you can use software to make your hardware even better. And so with that being said,
let's drop kick into some action with some Dead Island 2.
Let's do it.
The much-loved Zombie Saga is back. On April 21st, Dead Island 2 launched on PC and AMD-powered consoles.
Let's go!
It's this super fun, yet still surprisingly scary, zombie-slaying action-adventure RPG.
That's right. In this game, you can play solo or with friends, like I need to play with Adit to carry me in basically every game, in a zombie-infested recreation of LA. And on your adventures, you experience brutal combat, yet awesome zombie-slaying fun.
If you're looking to dive into Dead Island 2 on your Radeon-powered system, I got great news for you. This game runs incredibly on our hardware right now. If you're looking to play at 1080p, we recommend our AMD Radeon RX 6600 series. If you're playing at 1440p, again, our 6700 series with 12 gigabytes of video memory is a fantastic option. Lastly, if you're playing at 4K and you want an ultimate visual experience, featuring up to 24 gigabytes of video memory, our Radeon RX 7900 series are fantastic options for Dead Island. So Isaac, Dead Island 2 runs pretty good on our hardware. What if I want like a little more performance?
How about I give you a lot more performance?
I'll take it.
We're excited to share that FSR 2 is actually supported on Dead Island 2. Why don't we show you some footage of it in action?
Over the past few weeks, both Isaac and myself have been very active in reading your questions down below. We've seen questions come in on our hardware, what features to enable in our software, and what's the big deal with some of our platform technologies.
That's right. So to continue to engage with you guys and figure out what is a big deal, we're creating a new segment called our monthly tech tip. This month, we're focusing on Radeon Anti-Lag.
So Isaac, for the folks at home that aren't familiar with this technology, do you mind explaining how it works?
Yeah. What Radeon Anti-Lag does is that it reduces latency and improves responsiveness in some of your favorite games.
That sounds cool. How do I enable it?
You can enable it on a per-game basis or globally in AMD software. To do it on a per-game basis, you can just go into AMD software, click the Gaming tab, then choose your favorite game. From there, you're going to click the toggle to enable Radeon Anti-Lag, and you're good to go. For this month's software update, we're focusing on AMD Noise Suppression. If you don't know what this feature is, it's an AI-trained, real-time noise suppression feature that works right within AMD software.
What's really cool is it doesn't just work in your favorite games, but it works in your chat applications such as Discord and TeamSpeak. It works in your favorite streaming software such as OBS, as well as anything that you're doing for school or work such as Zoom or Microsoft Teams. What's also really cool is that this noise suppression works two ways.
So let's say Adit's carrying me in CS and we're on Discord, and while we're smoking down mid, my dog decides to bark behind me.
And my brother starts playing the drums.
Which plays way too often.
Way more than it should.
All I need to do is go into AMD software and enable AMD noise suppression, and it'll filter out the dog sounds and the drum sounds.
For the rest of the game, our teammates don't need to worry about what's going on behind me and Isaac. They just need to make sure they clear a firebox before we take sight.
That's right.
And that concludes our second episode. Thank you so much for tuning in.
This past month, we talked about our newest software optimizations to AMD noise suppression. Talked about exciting gameplay in Dead Island 2 with FSR2 support, and our new segment called the Monthly Tech Tip.
Check us out on Twitter, and by the time this video is up, we're going to have a new poll, and we want to ask you, the community, what do you want to see in next month's episode?
Continue to engage with us in the YouTube comments below, and we'll try to respond to as many as we can.
For now, I think it's time to just go home and slay some zombies.
Let's do it. See you on the next episode of Radeon Rewind.